Chapter 4 discusses making decisions. Before we get into the two types of decision structures or selection structures, we need to understand what a Boolean expression is. A Boolean expression is a comparison. The results of the Boolean expression is going to be either a true or false. Either the expression is true or the expression is false. These Boolean expressions are used in every selection structure. The question that is being asked in the diamond symbol of your flowchart, that question is really a Boolean expression. Let's look at the first type of selection structure. It's called a dual alternative, or binary, by being two, because it provides an action for each of the two possible outcomes. If the expression, remember the expression will be written inside the diamond of your flowchart. If the expression results to true, or yes, we follow this plan or path of action. The alternative is if the expression evaluates to false or no, then you follow a different plan of actions. In pseudocode, a dual alternative selection is often written as an if-then-else statement. The second type of selection structure is the single alternative or unary selection. Single being one action or path to follow. If the expression evaluates to true, you follow the path and perform some sort of action. If the expression evaluates to false, then there is no special action to take. We simply exit the structure. You could write your expression in such a manner that the plan of action is executed from the false results, but that's what we call negative logic, and we're going to discuss avoiding that. So it doesn't, the action does not always have to happen if the expression is true, but you do want to be careful on how you write your expressions. You want to make sure your logic is clear and understandable. So sometimes that negative logic can confuse people. The single alternative selection, when written in pseudocode, is often written as an if-then statement. If the expression is true, then do this. That's it. There's no else. The if-then-else decision, remember this is the dual alternative selection. The if line, if the condition is true, then the then clause. The then clause holds the action or actions that execute when the tested condition in the decision is true. If your Boolean expression evaluates to true, you do the actions within the then clause. If the Boolean expression evaluates to false, the then clause is skipped and the actions in the else clause are executed. Your Boolean expression does not have to be an equal symbol comparison. You don't have to write your Boolean expression as value 1 equals value 2. And remember, we want to make sure that we're talking about comparisons now. We quite often use the equal sign to do comparisons. Don't confuse that with Chapter 2 when we discussed assignment statements, and the assignment operator was also the equal symbol. These are comparisons. However, we are not going to limit ourselves to just equal to type comparisons. Most programming languages support 6 different types of comparison operators. All of these comparison operators will result in a true or false. You compare the two values by using either variables or constants or a combination of a variable and a constant. The term trivial expression is when you compare two constants. In this example, the digits 20, 20 equals 20, that's always going to be true. It's never going to change. So quite often in our expressions, we use variables because the data in the variable changes. It's not uncommon to compare a variable value to a constant. It's not uncommon to compare a variable to a variable. And when I say that, I mean the data in one variable compared to the data in another variable. But it is very trivial to compare a constant to a constant, because a constant never changes. Avoid comparing a constant to a constant. Here are the 6 relational operators that are commonly accepted, the equivalency operator or the equal to, greater than, less than, greater than or equal to, less than or equal to, and the not equal to. Now, once again, I'm going to say that depending on your language, when you actually write the code, these symbols may be slightly different depending on the language. Okay. Right. Any logical situation can be expressed with only the three types of comparisons: equal to, greater than, and less than. So technically, we could argue that you could throw out the greater than equal to and the less than or equal to, but that's kind of a debatable discussion. Now here it says it makes the code more readable. I would argue that that really depends on the individual. If you want to say, in Ms. Verrill's video on Boolean expressions, she talks about asking the computer a birth date. Is your birthday on or before July 1st? Well, if you want to be inclusive, including July 1st, you could just ask, is it before July 2nd? That would include July 1st, but not include July 2nd. It's arguable whether or not the less than or equal to, greater than or equal to, makes your code more readable. Just know that we always have the option that there's a workaround for these greater than or equal to, less than or equal to. Now the not equal operator, again, debatable, but I'm going to agree, probably the most confusing of comparisons. But the not equal to is asking if two variables are not equal. Here's some example flowchart and pseudocode using a negative comparison. Is the customer code not equal to 1? If the expression evaluates to true, or yes, in other words, the customer code is not 1, then the discount is 0.25. If the customer code not equal to 1 evaluates to false, which, think carefully, that means the customer code is equal to 1, then the discount is 0.50. Here's that pseudocode to match it. Customer code not equal to 1, then discounts 0.25, otherwise discounts 0.50. You can simply rewrite this to be using positive logic rather than negative logic. Instead of saying not equal to, and I want you to notice before we change slides, not equal to 1, discount 0.25. Equal to 1, discount 0.5. Notice that we're going to keep the negative or the false path on the left and the true path on the right, but notice the question will change and the actions will change. Customer code is equal to 1? Yes. Discounts 0.5. Customer code not equal to 1? Discount 0.25. Look at the pseudocode. Now, I'm going to back up a slide. Compare this pseudocode using straightforward or positive logic compared to the same logic, actions, but in negative logic. I would argue that using the not equal to causes a little bit more confusion. You certainly are welcome to disagree. Avoiding a common error with relational operators, be very careful. Read your code. Do a desk check. Read your logic. Walk through your pseudocode. Walk through your flowchart doing a desk check. Make sure you're using the correct operators. A very common error is missing that boundary or limit for a selection. Again, if we refer to the birth date being July 1st, you ask, is your birthday before July 1st? Well, do you want to include July 1st in your question? That's where you've got to ask. That's that boundary or limit they're talking about. If I ask you to pick a number between 1 and 5, between 1 and 5, does that mean 2, 3, or 4? Or are we being inclusive? 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Pick one of those. That's what we're talking about, the boundary or the limit. So be careful that you use the correct relational operator in your Boolean expressions.